45% of single men admit that they will go 4 months without cleaning their bed sheets.
4 months?
4 months.
Woody, why are you laughing like that?
I'm saying amateurs.
Oh my God, Woody, just so you have an idea, you're supposed to wash them every week.
Now that I have a girlfriend, I do wash them more often.
How often is more often?
When it was just me and the dogs, I didn't care.
It's a non-specified time.
Oh my God.
He's not willing to commit to.
You're supposed to wash them weekly.
Okay.
So...
This is the Woody and Jim Show podcast, a daily recap of everything you missed.
On Friday, Miley Cyrus released her new single called Flowers, and we were already obsessed with it. Like, we were playing it every single hour. And then it came out that there's, like, way more to the story about her song.
There's so much.
So she specifically released it on January 13th, on Friday, which happens to be Liam Hemsworth's 33rd birthday, is her ex-fiancé. Yeah. So she released a song on his birthday, and now there's a bunch of stories going around that apparently Liam, like, dedicated this song to her after they broke up. And so Bruno Mars, When I Was Your Man,
right?
They're saying that he dedicated that song to Miley Cyrus after they broke up. Like, hey, I should have done all of this when I was your man.
Right. And the lyrics are very similar.
Yes. So now there's like back and forth between the Bruno Mars lyrics and the Miley Cyrus lyrics. So basically her responding to him dedicating the song to her, but she's responding in this song form with these different lyrics. So I'm going to compare the two so you can see if you believe it or not.
Okay.
Okay.
So this is the first one. This is Bruno.
Flowers.
And then Miley. More to the song, Bruno. Miley's really coming for him here.
Wow, yeah.
This is the best part.
That's not a coincidence.
Yeah, right here is the best part. Miley said, I got this.
I can take myself dancing. And I can hold my head.
Wow.
That can't be a coincidence.
Yeah, no kidding.
Everyone knows I love a good petty move.
Oh, yeah.
And this is actually beyond petty.
It is.
This is like, yes. Yeah. And it's so, it's like brilliant petty, though.
Yeah.
Liam, you want some suntan lotion for that burn?
SPF 100,000.
I love this because there's also all these rumors coming out that he had cheated on her 14 times during the relationship.
Gosh.
Yeah, like excessively cheated on her.
Wow. Yeah.
There's a lot that goes into that. So this is like her just coming back at him in a major way.
And I feel like this sounds really, really awful, but when we were watching like the Miley Cyrus and Dolly Parton New Year's Eve, everybody was like, yo, Miley looks bomb.
Oh my God, she looks the best she's ever looked.
She looks good, she sounds good. Talk about revenge hot. Uh-huh.
Yes.
Then release this song, like that's take that.
Like she looks healthy and happy and she sounded phenomenal.
Yeah,
like,
I think that's the biggest part. She looks healthy and happy.
Yes.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
She looks like she's in a great place. And like she's putting out bangers again, and like, you know, so it's good.
Yeah,
and this is even more delicious.
Yeah, sometimes you need a good breakup,
Jim. I don't know why that just like you made me cringe a little bit, but I get
so
what you were saying, and I agree.
So yeah, if you want to hear them like side by side and all of the conspiracy theories, we do have them up on the website. It's just 1075theriver.com.
Every time we come back, especially after a 3-day weekend, we just kind of compare notes. Okay, what happened to you over the weekend?
Right? Yeah.
I'll tell you, like, my weekend was jam-packed. We had family in.
So busy and popular.
We did. Well, if you'd like to continue mocking me, we took almost all of your suggestions, Zach. So
thank you.
Keep mocking. We went to the Preds game on Saturday night.
Mm-hmm.
We spent, like, hours in Savannah's Candy on Broadway. Watching, you know, the party buses. Those plexiglass things are the best because they're like muffled.
They do kind of muffle the sounds, yeah.
Yeah.
It is kind of nice.
We went to Blade and Timber for axe throwing.
Fun.
Sweet.
Pins Mechanical for pinball.
Oh my God, Pins is my favorite.
It's so fun.
Love that place.
I love Pins.
And then we finished off the weekend watching Megan, the crazed robot child movie. That was hilarious.
Yeah, really cool.
Yeah, so it was packed. What about Ricki? What did you do this weekend?
Spent a lot of time with Zach.
And you survived?
And his friends and family.
All
and
sorts of stuff. Saturday family. Night we went to the Freddie Mercury tribute, which was really was that good.
The show was really good. It was at Marathon Music Works, and it was really good.
The guy was fantastic. That's cool. And then I spent like 8 hours in his hot tub on Sunday, which was unplanned. I just wanted to spend 2 hours there. I was there all day.
Are you still
pruny?
I feel pruny still. Yeah. I got to spend time with his mom, which I always love.
Oh, there's the worst ways to spend a day.
Right. And then what did we do? And then we went to the Preds game last night.
Yeah.
Oh, great.
Fantastic game.
Very cool.
Very intense.
Big win. That's awesome. What about Woody? What did you do?
My girlfriend Melissa was here, and we did a lot of things. We went out to dinner a few times to different places. We watched some movies. We went over to Jeff and Chris's, my son and his wife, and my grandkids, Ollie and Charlie. And we played Pie in the Face, which is a game where you have to click a little button and whipped cream flies into your face.
Oh, fun.
But
yeah.
They used to have one that just had a hand that would slap you in the face. Now it has like a cannon.
Oh.
So somebody else.
Oh, they supercharged it.
Yes.
My God.
I love this.
Also, we decided we were going to watch a movie that we both loved and hadn't seen together. So we watched Princess Bride. And then,
oh my God, a good choice.
I love
choice.
That movie.
Choice.
And then we went over to Jeff and Chris's, and Charlie, my granddaughter, was saying, I want to watch Princess Bride. Went, okay, one more time.
Yeah. Let's do it again.
It's inconceivable. Such a good movie. It makes you feel good. Zach, what'd you do?
Literally, that was it with Ricki.
Okay.
He
was with me all weekend.
We went to the show Sunday. We hung out in the hot tub. I had my mom over, and then my boyfriend's family came over. And then we went to the Preds game yesterday.
Very cool.
Usually you try to keep family away. Was it because they had to come see the hot tub?
Yes.
Okay.
Because we finally got the hot tub delivered. Everybody was like, all right, this is the weekend that we're coming to see the hot tub. I was perfect.
Do you regret getting the hot tub now?
No. I prefer them coming to my house instead of me having to drive out there because they live out Juliet.
That's right. I mean, that was my weekend.
You can also hide under the water if you need to.
Yeah.
Yeah, see, that's good.
It's time for men and women to answer questions for gender wars.
All right, representing the ladies in the audience, we have Mary Beth in Nashville. Good morning, Mary Beth.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good luck. For the guys, we have Josh. He's in Bowling Green. Hello, Josh.
Hello. Good morning.
Hello.
Glad to have you guys. Let's do a Get Acquainted question. Starting with you, Josh. What would you do if you had an extra hour every day? What'd you do with that hour?
Sleep.
Say, that's the answer I was looking for.
Totally get that.
It's never a bad answer, unless you're driving. Mary Beth, what would you do if you had an extra hour every day?
That's my answer, sleep.
Sleep.
Okay.
Everybody just wants some
more
sleep.
We all just want to sleep.
We'll do this try again tomorrow. If all we get is sleep, we're changing questions.
Yeah, that's right.
Because it's the obvious.
We all have something in common, though.
Exactly.
It's so true.
All right, we start with the multiple choice question for both of you. Remember, you have a screw you can use during the contest. If you can't answer the question, you can pass it on to your opponent, but they could steal your point. Mary Beth, in soccer, is the field they play on referred to as the gridiron, the pitch, or the stretch?
The stretch.
No, they call it the pitch.
Oh, it's the pitch.
It's the pitch.
It's okay. It's early.
Don't be. It's okay.
Still got plenty of time. All right, Josh, you ready for your first one?
Give it a shot.
Is the new season of RuPaul's Drag Race seen on TLC, Lifetime, or MTV?
Oh, gosh. The second one.
Lifetime? That's incorrect. It's seen on MTV.
Okay.
Still no score.
Mary Beth, who plays the part of Ant-Man in the Marvel movies? Oh.
I'm sorry. No time.
Paul Rudd is what we're looking for.
My favorite.
I know. He's the cute one. All right. Josh, you can score first and go ahead.
Simple Truth is the organic food store brand at which supermarket chain?
Kroger?
Kroger!
Yes.
There you go.
First right answer of the game. It's 1-0. Mary Beth, you got to get this one to keep the game going.
Mary Beth, in poker, if your hand contains a pair and a three of a kind, what is that called?
Straight.
Nope. It's a full house.
Yeah.
Full house. And that means 1-0, Josh. There's no way that Mary Beth can catch up. You are the winner.
Sorry, Mary Beth.
That's okay.
Hope you still had fun.
Good job, Josh.
But you're going to have an amazing day.
That's right.
You're going to have a day that's as awesome as you are.
Woody and Jim in the morning, 107.5 The River. We got Bonnaroo tickets for Amanda.
Oh, my God. I have to tell you, I did get through to Gender Wars, and Zach hung up on me.
Ooh. Oh, my God.
Well, yeah.
Luckily, justice has been served, and you've won a prize, despite Zach's efforts.
Yeah, the phone was kind of messed up. He was having trouble with it.
Yeah.
Hi, it's me. Yeah, I'm so sorry.
Mad, but you were redeemed.
I'm sorry. It was all my fault. I apologize.
Zach, this is where you say.
No, I love Zach.
It's me. The problem was me.
It was. Yeah. I was owning the moment. I apologize.
Everybody at tea time agrees.
Oh, my God. Zach's the anti-hero. Congratulations. Bonnaroo is going to be fantastic this year, and you're going to be there.
Oh, my gosh. Okay. Oh, awesome. I've never been. My fiance used to go like 6 years in a row, so he's going to be super excited.
All right.
Girl, you got to get your nipple tassels ready.
Exactly. That is a requirement. They will check for nipple tassels when you walk in. So
yeah. Just keep that in mind. Good luck with your first timer. It's going to be a blast. I love it.
Another chance to win. Nipple tassels not included. It's 5:40 this afternoon with Jonathan on 107.5 The River.
BYONP.
Trending. Here's what's trending this morning with Woody and Jim on 107.5 The
Mayhem.
River.
Ah, another confused yet excited listener.
I'm so sorry, Amanda.
Trending brought to you by Mark Spin Real Estate. Zach,
this is kind of wild that scientists are saying that lasers can actually move lightning strikes. Have you guys seen this story?
Move lightning strikes?
I heard about this. How does it work?
So it started in Switzerland, and there's like a huge tower that they wanted to protect. So they got like a car-sized laser that they shot into the sky to protect this tower. And so whenever lightning got close to the tower, the laser was able to actually move the lightning from hitting the tower.
Wow.
Is that not insane?
That could be...
Sounds like a sci-fi movie.
Yeah.
Like, apparently they've tried it multiple times, and this is the first time that it's worked in 40 years that they've been trying it.
That's wild.
Yeah. Mm. I'm like, I want one on top of my house.
Oh. There you go.
Of course you do.
Yeah.
So surprised.
Yes. Ricki, what you got?
So every year, White Castle does this fun thing for Valentine's Day where they make them all fancy inside.
Right.
We have a romantic dinner
and
at White Castle.
And they haven't done it for 2 years because of the pandemic. So this year, they are officially bringing it back. You can make your reservations if you'd like to go experience a fancy White Castle, which means that you have a hostess, a server. There's like holiday decor all over the place. There's more information at 107.5theriver.com, keyword Ricki, if you want to reserve a spot. Because there are two White Castles in this area that are actually doing this.
Yeah.
So cool. It could be fun. Jim?
Romantic.
So there's this Bellevue man, according to court records.
Headline, Bellevue man did what?
Bellevue man was driving drunk when he decided to let his 5-year-old son steer the car instead of him.
Oh, that is so dangerous.
They can't even steer with the steering wheel.
So obviously things went wrong and they slammed into a mailbox on Charlotte Pike. I guess the son is okay, but the driver grabbed the son and ran from the scene. And then they finally, they found open bottles and stuff. And then they finally tracked down the guy's house. And when they were there, the 53-year-old man was trying to get away in his wife's car down the driveway.
Wow.
Without the kid.
So. Wow. As long as the kid's okay.
Yeah, I believe it is okay.
So that's a good thing.
Woody and Jim in the morning on 107.5 The River.
It's a really sweet story. There's a little girl who is fighting cancer and going through cancer treatments, going through chemo, and her name is Delilah. And she loves the song by the Plain White Tees, Hey There, Delilah. And
I guess she
would listen to that while she was having her chemotherapy and everything. And I guess it helped soothe her nerves and kind of get her through everything. And her mom and dad were waiting for another treatment to come on. She was in the hospital. And all of a sudden, they got a message on their phone and wanted to know if she wanted to see it.
You want to watch it? Okay.
What's up, Delilah? It's Tom from Plain White Tees. I hear you're a big fan of our song, Hey There, Delilah. So figured that I would play it for you right now. So here we go. Actually, you know what? I got a better idea. Hang on a second.
And then he enters
the room.
He was on the phone, and then all of a sudden he just said, okay, I'm coming in. Delilah, and he walks in the hotel or in the hospital room.
Hey there, Delilah. What's it like in New York? York City, I'm 1,000 miles away, but girl, tonight you look so pretty. Yes, you do.
Oh my God.
The face she has is just
so
sweet.
It was so sweet.
So cute.
Yeah.
Oh, man, I got goosebumps.
It makes you tear up a little bit.
Yeah, it's very, very sweet. Right. If you want to see the entire video, Woody posted it. If you follow him on Twitter, it's just at Radio Woody.
Yeah.
And you can watch the entire video. It's so sweet. Yeah, like, seeing her expression.
Yeah. That's the best thing ever. Yeah. That's what's making us happy this morning with Woody and Jim on 107.5 The River. Now, Zach, you and Ricki had a shared awkward experience over the weekend.
Yeah, well, basically, number
one. I don't even know if I would say awkward as much as terrifying.
Terrifying. All right, let's go with terrifying.
We spent the entire weekend together, basically.
Yes.
Which is terrifying.
But wait, it gets more terrifying?
Then it's even more terrifying. Ricki met her future.
No.
Her future? What do you mean?
No.
Of an awful child.
Not my future.
Oh, so you've decided that Ricki is going to have a devil child.
100%, without a doubt.
Children, this is it. Tell us this kid. Like, what was it about this kid that made him a devil?
Ricki, go ahead.
I don't like to speak ill about children, but this child really was just too much.
Okay, let's just give him a name. Let's just call him Terence. That's not
Terence.
His name. But
all
just
right.
Like, tell us about Terence.
He has more personality than any child should ever have.
Okay.
I was talking to him.
Yes.
And he looked me dead in the eyes and told me, well, my teachers are all stupid. And I know 100 trillion million times things more than they know. And I was like, okay, sir. And I told him, well, you know, like, your teachers are people that you should respect, and they
right.
know a lot more than you know. And immediately this child looks at me and goes, I am so over this conversation. I do not want to speak to you anymore.
Like, gets up. Flips his wrist and walks away and goes, I am so over this conversation.
That was after the initial meeting of this child and I, was that he had told me that he was a dog. So I was like, oh, what kind of dog are you? And he goes, a mean dog, I'm going to bite you. And I was like,
wow.
Oh,
down Terence.
My God.
Yeah.
Terence the Terrible.
A lot. Just more personality than any 4-year-old should have.
And that's saying a lot
because
she was around me.
He's 4?
Yes.
Terence is 4 and already has that attitude that he's the smartest thing and is over with every conversation?
And he's the dog that will
bite you.
Bite you.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
My gosh.
Yeah.
Wow.
He was a lot. It was a fantastic birth control for me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly.
I think I'm good now. I'm set with it.
Terence, can you stand next to that condom machine over there?
Literally was like, yeah.
Literally, oh, my God.
He was like screaming at Ricki, and Ricki looked at me and whispered and goes, this is my nightmare.
All right.
Wow.
At one point, I started screaming back at him because I was like, I'm not dealing with you anymore. I quite literally was like, I'm not taking this.
Yeah.
I think we've all been in situations like that where we're grown adults, but we're afraid of a little child.
Terrified.
Yeah. <It's> evil.
So I'm the only one that saw Megan, but you know the concept of Megan, the you know, robot doll child.
Right.
That goes
a friend and also seeks vengeance.
Goes berserk.
Yes.
So who would win in a fight, Terence or Megan the robot doll?
Terence 100%.
Without a doubt.
Megan doesn't stand a chance.
Yeah.
Wow.
Against pieces.
This devil child.
Wow.
Without a doubt. I pray for their teachers every day.
He just like started screaming obscenities, like things that he should never ever even know.
And he's 4.
Yes. God. Yes.
Kids aren't supposed to turn into jerks till they're like 8.
Yeah.
The curse words that were coming out of his mouth.
A lot of people on social media have been worried that instead of eggs, we may have to paint potatoes for Easter.
They are extremely expensive.
This idea, though, of painting
potatoes
instead.
I mean, it could be fun.
Right?
Could be so much more
surface area to work
That's
with.
That's true. You got a much larger palette.
You could make like a true masterpiece
you
on
could.
A potato.
You really could.
I was just seeing that the CEO of Kroger said they're going to start limiting the number of eggs people can buy.
Yeah.
How many eggs can I buy?
I think it was like 3 dozen, but it may get lower.
Yo, that's a lot.
3 dozen eggs is a lot.
That's a lot.
I will say
if we are painting eggs for painting potatoes for Easter.
Yes.
Honestly, at least it's useful at that point because the potatoes can be outside for a while and then you can still cook them afterward versus the eggs, they go bad.
Look at you, Zach.
Yeah, unless you just eat them.
I mean, if you hard boil them, yeah.
Do you not hard boil your eggs before you paint them, Zach? Because you're supposed
you
to.
You don't paint raw eggs.
You what? Have to hard boil them
that
first.
That is terribly.
Dodo brain.
Yeah. I had no idea.
You don't give a bunch of little kids like raw eggs to paint.
Yeah.
Zach,
this is a great idea.
Eggs are so fragile. You think that children should have raw, fragile eggs in their hands as they paint them?
Because you know they won't throw them. That's for sure.
Yeah, or drop them.
I literally never even thought about it.
Oh my God.
Wow. It's funny, social media's been full of all kinds of memes of, you know, because eggs are so expensive. They have like a girl on the beach and the guy is like proposing on one knee, opening up a carton of eggs. And she goes, he went to Kroger.
It's
so romantic.
Here's what's trending this morning with Woody and Jim on the river.
Brought to you by Mark Spain Real Estate. A couple on TikTok were bragging about how they are able to save money. I guess they've decided they're going to put $5 in a piggy bank every time they have intimate relationships.
That's a lot.
And ooh, so they got $1,300 last year. So 260 times.
Oh,
they
wow.
are living in Pound Town.
Good tips.
I may try that by the end of the year. I might have $5.
I'm exhausted thinking about it.
That's something, Woody. Might as well.
That's right. Don't give up on your dreams.
$5. $5.
Ricki, what you got?
Men are disgusting, and I have the proof.
Duh.
Yes.
So there was a new survey that went out.
As you're talking to an entire room full of men. Yeah. Tell us how nasty we are.
We agree.
There was a survey that went out that found that 45% of single men admit that they will go 4 months without cleaning their bed sheets.
4 months?
4 months.
Woody, why are you laughing like that?
I'm saying amateurs.
Oh my God, Woody, just so you have an idea, you're supposed to wash them every week.
Now that I have a girlfriend, I do wash them more often.
How but often when it was is
just,
more often?
When it was just me and the dogs, I didn't care.
It's a non-specified time.
Oh my God.
She's not willing to commit to.
You're supposed to wash them weekly.
Okay.
So...
Is that spelled W-E-A-K? I wash them weekly. Very weekly.
Oh, my God. Well, point proven, men are nasty.
Yes, we are.
Jim, what do you got?
Good news is the Titans went undefeated in the beginning of the playoffs for the NFL. They didn't play.
Yeah.
Didn't lose.
I literally thought, I was like, wait, what?
Catching sleepy people. There also is a lot of talk, people wondering, is Tom Brady he's a free agent. Is he going to become a Titan? Because he used to play with Mike Vrabel, our coach. Who knows? But here's something pretty interesting. The way the playoffs worked out, the Buffalo Bills and the Cincinnati Bengals will meet again after the last time was with the DeMar Hamlin.
Right, where they had to postpone the game, yeah.
But I'm fairly positive they are going to meet in a central site, or neutral site, rather, in Atlanta, because that was part of the agreement of them, canceling the game. If they met again in the playoffs, that they would go to a neutral site.
Interesting.
So, yeah.
I would love to see the Bills win the Super Bowl just because of all they've been through. And,
yeah, absolutely.
DeMar Hamlin.
DeMar Hamlin. Yeah. Yeah, that'd be great.
You mean you want them to attend the Rihanna concert?
Exactly.
Yeah. They get
to wear uniforms to the Rihanna concert.
Yeah.
Over the holidays, a lot of people like to put their best foot forward and kind of impress people that come over to the house.
Yeah, and this one person did something that is really ticking people off. There was a Chicago bookstore, and bookstores are barely trying to stay alive.
Oh, the
right?
brick and mortar buildings. Yeah, bookstores.
And they're a small business, right? So somebody comes in just recently, and they returned $800 worth of books.
Really?
And they said, you know, we're returning them because we don't want them anymore. We just bought them to put on the shelf and stage our house while people came over during the holidays.
Oh. I mean, I get that.
To look like they're big readers.
Oh, wow.
Especially if you have, in-laws coming, you want to look smart.
That's pretty low, though.
But the small business says, that was, a good portion of our rent that you just returned.
I mean, I kind of feel bad for them, but also that's your return policy. That's not my fault. That's your return policy.
Yeah, they're definitely updating that.
Yeah.
But these people, they didn't care. Just we're just going to take your stuff for a month and then just try to pretend we're literate. and make themselves
look
better.
I feel like you're talking about me. That's 100% something
I
would do.
He was staring right at you when you said that.
Totally would do this.
Without a doubt would do that.
Well, I know a lot of people, like in real estate, if they're going to show a house, you know, they'll put like, you know, cookies baking or something, or they'll put like books up on the shelf, but they usually go to like, you know, Goodwill or a used bookstore or something.
Right, or they use the same ones, like when they're done with the one in one house, they bring them to the next.
Yeah.
I do this all of the time.
Do you?
Yes.
Yeah, you said you had a lot of examples, but one of them was personal, which
mine
sounds
is very
like
personal.
Has something to do with people in this room.
Yes. So I feel bad saying this out loud.
Oh my God.
When do you ever feel bad about saying this?
You never feel bad. This must be really
bad. This must be really bad.
Whenever people buy me things that don't fit the aesthetic of my house, I put them in a closet and I only put out like the gifts that you bought me when you're coming over.
So you think everybody that
they're
always
on display.
Oh, I think
everybody does that. Like when your mom is coming over and you have this ugly, you know, like commemorative plate.
Yeah,
that you didn't
bring up
want,
the cutting board that she made
me.
Oh,
yeah. Oh, everybody does that.
Or like the mirror that Woody bought me for my birthday. It only goes on the wall when you're there.
And I'm never at your house. I don't even know where your house is.
It's in the mirror you bought me is in the closet.
I bought him a big giant mirror saying this is the picture you want to see all the time, and it's you.
Well, so if you ever buy me anything,
while accurate, he hides it.
Yeah.
Damn.
Zach, do you hide my housewarming present?
No, actually.
Really?
No. Yeah. Gym so special. Jim bought me a piece of the B&A carpet.
Right, right.
Is it not my...
Is it like a doormat?
By my front door.
Is it?
Yeah.
She is not backing you up.
I know.
It's literally there.
The Ew David one.
It's on the outside. As soon as you walk in on the inside, the welcome mat is the mat that Jim bought me.
Okay.
See, I've never noticed just because the dogs get really excited to see me, so I've just never noticed it because it's normally where the dogs meet me.
Right.
But yeah, just for future reference, if you ever buy me anything, it's usually in the closet and it's only on the counter whenever you come over.
That is a very Zach move, though.
It is.
I don't think anyone's shocked by this.
No, if it doesn't fit my aesthetic, thank you for buying it for me.
But I also get it. Like, that's reasonable.
Yeah. I mean, there was an ugly, like, this house is the home of blah, blah, blah. That was like a rock you're supposed to put in the, like, walkway up to the front door that somebody gave us. And we were like... That's only coming out when they come back to visit.
Yeah. That's what I put out.
Thanks for listening to and recommending the Woody and Jim Show podcast. Listen to Woody and Jim in real time every weekday morning on 107.5 The River, Nashville, or live on the iHeartRadio app.